What's going on, guys? Welcome to JHouze Radio, episode 60. Can't believe we made it to 60 episodes, guys. Appreciate your support. Appreciate the love from everybody in the community. Today's episode is going to be a little different. I gave Los off this time because, you know, I figured why not. The guy works hard. He gets a lot to the studio. Even though the people love him, had to give him a break. This episode is going to be a little different. Pretty much, I feel like I say that almost every episode. Every episode is different at this point. There's no point of even saying that anymore. Every episode is different. There's always something new going on. There's always something wacky happening. This episode is going to be a very different one. It's going to be a crossover podcast with JHouze Radio and Divided We Fall Gaming podcast. We're doing a podcast together. Me, Juan, Adams, Bojo, and it's going to be interesting. We're talking about the best video game consoles of all time and our opinions. So don't at us. Don't shame us. Don't ridicule us for our picks. This is our opinion. This is something that we feel passionate about. So we had a great roundtable discussion. I recorded the podcast prior to me talking at this moment. So I'm going to play that for you guys here. I think it was a fun discussion. It was great having the guys on the show. We had a great time doing it. I'm actually thinking about bringing the guys back again for some more interesting video game topics. So enjoy it. Check it out. Have a listen. Also, don't forget to support these guys, DWF, on Twitter. Check out Divided We Fall Gaming Podcast, wherever you can find podcasts. And don't forget, if you're watching this on YouTube, if you're listening to this, hit that like button, subscribe, hit the bell so you guys can be notified whenever we go live with the podcast. Yes, the podcast is live on youtube.com/TheJHouze. If you guys are checking the audio version out, leave us a comment. We love to see some comments. It'll also help us out in the algorithms in the podcast world. Also, if you guys want to submit a question, we could read questions out on the podcast. Like, I think that'll be a great idea to have a podcast episode where we just answer any questions that you guys have, whether it's about what's our favorite movie, our favorite games, our favorite chicken, what junk food we like, or like whatever. I mean, any question, it doesn't matter. There is no limit. So if you guys are on Twitter, hit hashtag JHousePod. Leave your questions. We'll pick up the questions there and we'll answer them live on the show. Other than that, here we go. I'm going to play this audio for you. Like I said, it was a fun time. You guys will love this panel. This panel is hilarious and they're great people. JHouze Radio, episode 60. Best console of all time. What's going on, guys? Welcome to JHouze Radio, episode 60. The panel looks a little bit different today. We got some guests from the DWF gaming community. Bojo, Juan, and Adams. Say what's up, guys. How's it going?
Hey.
So, Adams, I think you and Juan, you guys are the founder of DWF, right? Both of you guys?
Me, him, Brutus, and Bojo.
So obviously besides the people who are listening to this on a DWF side, break it down to the people a little bit about DWF. What are you guys about?
Community, so, sarcasm, spirited conversation.
Arguments
just not so bad.
It really just started as a community of like people that just had like-minded interests, namely video games. But, what's kind of cool is that as a community, it's kind of started to like, it's the differences in each other that we really started to appreciate, you know. And it's just all these different personalities that are coming together and enjoying gaming. And I think one thing that like Adams has done really well with the community is embracing like every genre of video game that people want to play. He's in it. I know I've tried new things because of it. Yeah.
For, like, especially our community nights.
Yeah, community nights do get a little wacky. I mean, you guys got me playing Fortnite, for crying out loud, and I don't play Fortnite.
No, no. No building got everybody playing Fortnite.
Yeah, yeah. Honestly,
that's what it was. If that goes away, I'm done with it.
Yeah, I don't know who to blame for that, but yeah. I don't know how that happened, but
it's not us.
Yeah, definitely not, because building was the reason why I stayed away from that game. No build came around. I was on it, for sure, for sure. But yeah, speaking of games, tonight we're going to be talking about our favorite game console of all time. Obviously, everybody's has their opinion on it, so it's very subjective. But before we jump into that, anybody on the JHouze Radio side, I want them to kind of get to know you guys a little bit. So we're going to start off with some icebreaker questions. So we're going to start off with you, Juan. Wings or pizza?
No, it's not me.
Oh, I'm going to have to go with wings. Traditional wings.
Traditional,
nuggets. Yeah,
no nuggies.
Yeah, which I know
no nuggies
probably bother some people, but no, traditional wings, done right, so good.
Adams
Tuesday,
boneless Tuesday. Yeah, boneless wings for me, for sure. Boneless wings.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, wings
are
bone.
KJ,
but that's the reason why, man. I don't have time to sit here and like wipe my fingers off, lick, like, I just want to get into the chicken, eat it, and be done. I don't have time for all that extra stuff.
Here's my problem with boneless. Most restaurants, when they try to do boneless, the batter is too thick, man. The batter to chicken ratio is
really thick. I feel like it's the other way around for me. I feel like the batter is too thick
too
when it comes
to chicken.
No, I feel like the batter is too thick when it comes to the bone in wings. Like, it's just too much.
No, there's no, I don't, not even. What batter? You fry the chicken, toss the the sauce, and you're done. You're going to the wrong place if you're getting
batter. Probably. Yeah,
Buffalo Wild Wings isn't the place to go.
Oh, don't. No. Adams. Well, no. All right. Adams, we were friends. Let's not destroy that.
I will say, no.
Here.
Seriously.
Spicy garlic and honey barbecue from Buffalo Wild Wings. I'll tear that up.
Asian zing. Look, here. Man. Asian zing.
Asian zing.
Oh, all the disagreements we've had, it's going to take more than some wings to break
for
up.
Sure. All right, Adams, what about you? Wings or pizza?
I'm going to go with wings.
Okay. Bojo?
Pizza. 100%.
Wow. Okay. What kind of pizza?
I'm going to get a lot of shit for this.
Oh, boy. Wait. Yeah, just don't say pineapple.
That's what's coming out of her mouth.
That's what's coming.
They're going to say
100%. Look at that face.
Oh my goodness. You're off the show.
Pizza. It's so good. Sweet and savory. It's good.
Sweet. Wow. She sounds like a commercial. Sweet and savory.
I love
not a toddler's.
Okay. Pineapple and ham. That's adulty.
Jeez, Louise. Chat. What is.
Had ham?
Yes.
What? Not on your pizza, though. Like, there are just some things.
Cheese and tomato sauce?
Ham on pizza is not bad. It's the fucking problem.
Yeah, of course.
Well, you guys hate fruits and vegetables, so I don't want to hear it.
You are 100% correct.
That is true. I gotta like force myself to eat fruits and vegetables.
I love fruit. Pineapple's my favorite.
I do too.
Jeez Louise.
Chat.
Chat, let us know, guys. Wings or pizza, let us know. And we're going to get to the console talk in a minute. I see people are already throwing down their favorites in chat already. mine's obviously
idea.
I see. Mine is obviously wings, hands down. I like pizza, but being that I have kids, I'm just pizzaed out, so yeah. Wings for me.
My wife is a huge pizza. That's her all day.
Yeah. What's her favorite topping?
Oh, she goes straight pepperoni. Just pepperoni and cheese. Nothing
else. Wrong with the classic.
Keep it simple. Yeah. Keep it simple. No, don't put those weird crap on.
But thin crust or thick? That's the question.
Ooh, that's a good question.
Give me a normal crust. If we're really talking, like, what's the name of that dude from Dave Portnoy? The Barstool guy?
I'm not sure.
He tastes all the pizzas.
Yeah. That dude, his criteria is pretty solid.
Okay.
When it comes
okay.
to crust and, you know, getting that like charred bubbles, like good we're, brick oven pizza.
I love a good bubble.
We're talking to you, not him.
Jeez Louise.
Well, I was just saying, I agree with his criteria.
The hostility has already begun.
It's, man.
Oh, yeah.
How is that hostile? It's just a very simple statement.
Shut up.
The hostility is bubbling.
I agree with his criteria. You don't want a too soggy of a, I don't want to, it's not the crust, the bread, the floor.
Oh, the floor.
So, I don't know.
Can I get some pizza with some stiff floor, please? All right, so our next icebreaker that we're going to jump into is we're going to start with you, Bojo. First person shooter or horror games? You have to pick one.
First person shooter. I can't play horror games.
Really?
Yeah,
I thought
does.
You liked horror games.
So, okay, so here's my thing. I love to watch horror games, and I'll play horror games with a friend, but I will never play a horror game. Never, ever.
Wow. I did not see that coming. I thought you was like the horror game queen. Okay.
Oh, no, I'm a big baby.
Juan?
Oh, you as much as Bojo says she's a big baby, I'm a bigger bitch when it comes to horror games.
Come on.
I played Phasma with everybody when it came out, and I'm pretty sure I screamed the loudest, bitched out the loudest, and never bought another horror game after that.
Jeez Louise.
I don't know. Like, I can't handle the rush gets way too real for me. I can't do it.
Horror games let everybody know who you really are deep down inside. Adams, I think I know your answer, but go ahead.
I'm taking horror games all day.
Okay. Okay.
All Good day. One. I hate fucking playing them, but.
Yeah, same here. Same here.
People seem to like watching it, so I'll keep doing it.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. I love the jump scares, yeah.
I used to be big into RPGs, like, as, like, a younger gamer. Like, Final Fantasy, so on and so forth. But mm-hmm. as I got older, yeah, horror games was my jam. So, I blame that on Resident Evil.
I can't get into art. I mean, I can. I still love RPG games, but I don't have the time to sink into them like I used to.
Yeah, I think that's what it is. I think it's the time sink. The time sink makes it a little difficult.
Shooters, on the other hand, you pick them up and let's go.
Exactly. All right, Juan, we're going to start off with the third one with you. Ninja Turtles or Power Rangers? You keep one and the other one cease to exist. Gotta pick one.
Oh shit.
Is it a certain version of each one or just in general?
Just in general. The entire franchise. Yeah. It's a tough one. It's a tough one.
Very tough.
Yeah, Daniel's in chat. I see you, buddy.
Yeah. The only thing that caused me I'm gonna go Ninja Turtles. And the only reason I had trouble coming to that decision is cause that means the Pink Ranger would never exist, and that was my childhood crush.
So you're keeping Ninja Turtles, or you're getting rid of
Ninja Turtles? Oh,
okay,
okay. Rid of Power Rangers.
Okay.
I mean, April O'Neil and the Pink Ranger is a lateral move for me.
Ooh, I didn't even think about that. I did not even think about that.
April O'Neil is why I like redheads.
I think April O'Neil was every little kid's, like, every little male's crush back in the day, man. Her now, Yellow Jacket.
I gotta say the Pink Ranger took that, but April O'Neil was there for sure.
Too. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
True.
Saved by the Bell had a lot of heartbreaks.
Adams?
It's Ninja Turtles for me.
Keeping? Okay.
Easy. Not, I mean, like, you got the cartoons, but then you got the movies, comics. Too.
Oh, the movies, yeah.
True indeed.
And the comics.
Yeah,
without the Ninja Turtles, we don't have The Last Ronin. We don't have Secret of the Ooze. I love Ninja Turtles, man.
And the first Ninja Turtles movie is the best movie. Side note.
The second one is the best one.
Jeez Louise.
But that's not
what Bojo, you about. Too? Are you serious? The movie is horrible. What is it about?
I like the first one. But the second one is just a funner movie.
Yeah.
The second one really takes what turtles are, fun teenagers. The first one is so dark, and Raphael spends half of it in a bathtub.
Yeah, he did.
Then he got absolutely walloped by the Foot Clan.
Oh yeah, he
all
did.
90 of them that was there.
Seriously. All right, Bojo, Which one are you keeping? Which one are you getting rid of forever?
Ranger, I'm keeping Power Rangers.
Wow.
I gotta tell us. Tommy was the love of my life. Whenever I was a kid,
the Green Ranger.
I was also the pink Power Ranger, like 6 years in a row for Halloween when I was a kid.
Are you serious?
I just want to know how Tommy blew on that flute with a mask on.
Nobody knows.
Wow, you know what? I didn't even think about that. I did not even think about that. Jeez.
Yeah, neither did the creators of that show, because he just does it all the time.
It's like,
I remember correctly, with the Power Rangers, so like all of the action sequences were the Japanese show, and only the American actors, like during the talking scenes and dialogue scenes, those were filmed in America, right?
That was correct.
Oh, really?
And they still follow that model today.
Really?
Really?
That I didn't know. That's pretty cool.
That's interesting. I actually didn't think that they still follow that model. I didn't even know that Power Rangers was still even on at this point, because I have not kept up with that.
They're on like Power Ranger Infinity Stone Saga right now.
All right, what's everybody's favorite Power Ranger? Well, we already know Bojo, you like the Pink Ranger, right?
Yeah.
Like you said. Adams?
It's the Green Ranger.
Okay.
It was black, but then Tommy came out and that was it.
Yeah, it's got to be Green Ranger.
Yeah, Tommy killed it for everybody. I mean, for me, you know, I got to be typical. You know, the Black Ranger was my favorite Power Ranger. So, you know. I thought it was kind of funny when it came out with the newer Power Ranger movie, they made the Black Ranger the Blue Ranger instead of making him the Black Ranger, just to try to get away from the stereotypes. Yeah, it was actually kind of funny.
My favorite Rangers were always the when they were the ninjas. That was my favorite. Outside of the original, there's the OG, and then when they were like ninjas, I thought was really cool.
Yeah, that was pretty cool. I did like that
Mighty one. Morphin. Mighty Morphin is prime Power Ranger.
Absolutely. Oh, yeah.
All right, so our last iceberg that we're going to jump into here, and we'll start off with Bojo again. What is a game that everyone loves but you hate?
Oh no! Fucking Fortnite! God, I hate that game.
I thought you loved the game with the no building and all that stuff.
So listen, I play that game to play with my friends, and that's it. Okay. Hate Fortnite.
Jeez Louise.
Oh, everybody loves that stupid game. I hate it.
I feel you.
That's a good question.
It makes me angry.
Adams, how about you, buddy?
I feel like I've got
Halo.
Oh no, come on, bro.
All
iterations. Why did you do did you even play all iterations? Are you serious?
I played enough to know I don't like it.
Okay, just about to end this early and kick us all out.
Seriously, like, you know what, guys? The podcast has to end now.
Oh no, I'm having internet issues.
Seriously. Thanos in chat says that Zelda is one game that he hates that everybody else loves. That's a deep cut right there, man.
I've actually never played a Zelda game.
That one cuts 30 years ago. How?
You've never played a Zelda game?
No.
All right, so...
And you're a gamer?
I get, because she didn't have systems until Breath of the Wild.
That's not true.
She's a child.
Super Nintendo and a Sega Genesis.
But Juan is our age, so at some point he should have picked up that fucking gold cartridge and put it in that NES.
I don't know what it was. I don't know if it was just... I don't know what turned me off about that game. And the thing is my wife, who doesn't even game, even she's played Ocarina of Time.
Wow. Okay.
But I just never picked that.
That is the best one.
I'm not saying I dislike it. I'm just saying I've never played it.
Wow. I think we might have to retire your controller, because if your wife has played that game and she's not even a gamer, that's pretty big, man. That's pretty big. For me, it's probably going to be Apex Legends. I mean, I see why people like it. I can't get with the gunplay. The gunplay just doesn't fit me. It doesn't fit my style.
Really?
Yeah, it's just I've tried it so many times.
I can't see anything. I don't know how people hit shots.
Yeah, I can't see nothing. Fortnite, it's easy to see anime characters jumping across your screen.
Yeah,
you got these dudes fucking. Yeah, Apex is rough now for me.
Yeah, that is pretty rough, man. It's pretty rough. All right, cool beans. Let's get ready to jump into our main topic here, which is what is our best console of all time. Adams, we're going to start with you. What is your favorite console of all time, in your opinion, and why?
And PS2.
Okay,
I love the game catalog that it has. And it did a lot to set up future consoles. It added being able to watch DVDs, internet, all sorts of different stuff.
Okay. Yeah, you know, I actually forgot that it went online.
Yep.
It had a very
I completely
rough,
forgot about that, yeah.
Yeah, it had a really rough internet.
I was looking at the features earlier, and it said you could get on there with fucking dial-up. So that tells you where it was at.
Jeez Louise, remember dial-up?
A lot of people forget that it had internet capabilities. I never used it because I didn't know how.
No, I don't think anybody ever used it, especially because...
I had dial-up, and that's why I didn't use it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
I couldn't imagine playing a game on dial-up.
That oh no, definitely
exhausting.
Not.
Yeah,
definitely
I,
not.
I want to say, I'm trying to think back to like the menu, right? Because I think you could browse the internet. Like it was just a browser.
You yes, I think you could.
It was a browser, dude. Wow, how do I not remember that? It was a
you
browser.
You could actually play games on it too.
On the browser?
No. On the PS2 online.
It had multiplayer type deal?
Jeez,
sure
I do not remember that. Wow.
I mean, interesting. Look, the PlayStation 2 was a great console. And yeah, I mean, I have great memories about it. I remember, it was funny, so obviously my parents bought the console, specifically my dad. And anytime a new console came out, you know, I was always harping like, hey dad, you know, can you buy me a Nintendo 64 or whatever?
Yeah.
And I remember the PlayStation 2 came out and it was kind of pricey. And I
yeah, it was
thinking,
expensive.
Like, man, that's an expense. And usually we only got new consoles if the old one was broken. Well, I still had a Nintendo 64 that worked fine. But when the PS2 came out, I didn't ask for it. And I just remember my dad like, do you want a PlayStation? Like, yeah.
So like, yeah. Sure,
so
why not?
On Christmas.
Yes,
I think
I
my dad's always been like secretly like into the video game.
Okay.
He used to hold a Nintendo 64 controller like this, and just the finger like the joystick and stuff like that.
Amateur move.
Oh yeah, he would always want to play FIFA. But anyways,
to be fair though, the Nintendo 64 controller is strange.
It is a weird controller, especially where the Joy-Con is that? I mean, not Joy-Con. The thumbstick. It's like right in the middle of the controller. It's like, why?
And then you got the two triggers up top, the Z in the back, and then two more on the left. Yellow buttons on the right.
It was always awkward. So awkward. And old.
Yeah, it was. It was really weird.
Especially with little hands, like as a kid.
Jeez, Louise.
Hey, right. don't shit talk the Nintendo 64 so much, right? Keep it on the PS2.
Yeah.
64 is one of my favorite consoles as well.
I know, but I'm just saying, you're going to take away my thunder.
What's your favorite game on the PS2, Adams?
Final Fantasy X.
Okay.
Easy.
Should have figured that. I
know with me, PlayStation 2, favorite game, and I still miss this game a lot. And it was I don't know if it was a big title, but it was called Kill Switch.
Yeah,
Kill Switch. I feel like I know that one.
They had sequels on PS3.
Did they
and
really?
Two, I think. Yeah.
Cool.
I want to say they even had one on PS4.
Kill Switch had a. We think because I remember it's. I hope I'm remembering it correctly.
I'm about to look that up right now.
I hope. Well, I think we are.
Kills. Oh yeah, I do remember that game. I don't remember if I played it, but that cover looked really familiar though.
The reason I remember really liking this game was because it was one of the first games I remember where it had like true like cover mechanics. Where
no,
you
I'm
actually like.
The game.
Yeah, I say I don't think it had anymore. It was a one-time deal. Trust me, I would have bought the sequel. But yeah, it even says on the cover, "Take cover, take aim, take over." Because I remember this is one of the first games where like you would actually be able to like take real cover. You know what I'm saying?
It was like Gears before Gears.
Yeah. Okay. I don't think you had the cover to cover system where you could like
bounce on
Gears.
Yeah.
But you could run and dodge, and I just remember I had a lot of fun with that game. That one and another relatively small title called Black.
I do remember that one. That was a good one.
Yeah.
I like Black, that one.
And I wish that, and it had like no real story. It was just a really fun shooter, and then never heard anything else about it again.
Back in the day when times were simpler. Bojo, what is your favorite console of all time and why?
It's a hard question. I think it might be a tie between the PS2 and the Sega Genesis, because I have the most memories with those consoles. And okay. I was a big Sonic fan whenever I was a kid, still am.
Yeah, same and here.
I spent the most time on those two consoles. They were multiplayer. I had siblings, so like it was just the console, or like both of them were just all we played whenever we were kids.
Okay. Cool beans.
Yeah. I know, I figured for this ranking, like nostalgia is such a huge factor when you look
at
the
console, right? And growing up, it was either a Sega or a Super Nintendo, and we got the Sega. And I remember I had a lot of fun with, obviously, Sonic. But Street Fighter was, like, the first time that I played it on a console. I think it came out on Sega. Mm-hmm. I know it was on Super Nintendo, too. That was a lot of fun. Because you would see it in the arcades.
Mm-hmm.
You could finally bring that experience home. That was pretty dope.
Played a lot of The Lion King and Sonic on... Oh, man.
It was so hard. Lion King? Oh, that was so hard.
I still have it beat. I don't know that the fourth level exists.
there was a glitch, if I remember correctly, with something like that with the fourth level. Like, it would glitch out. And so...
And never appear? Because
I don't know.
Never appear?
Never. I actually got fed up. And I not too long ago, I YouTubed the endings to that game and the endings to Aladdin.
But it's just a movie.
it's a very shitty version of the ending of the movie, but yeah. I wanted to see it, damn it. And all its 64-bit glory or whatever, 8-bit glory.
I feel like those old school games were just so freaking hard. I don't even remember beating any game back in the day. It's like, did I even beat anything at all, or did I just play just to play?
Like, there was a couple games. Game for the Super Nintendo that beat my ass all the time as well.
Mm-hmm.
You
had to fight the little clay guys, and it was so hard. There was also a fighting game for the Sega. I was confused.
I remember the Ninja Turtles fighting game. That was pretty cool.
No, Power Rangers.
Oh, that one too.
Yes, mm-hmm. The Power Rangers. Oh, I thought that was such a good game.
Mm-hmm.
Power Rangers were good. All right, so I guess I'll go next. My favorite console of all time, Nintendo 64, hands down.
My man.
I freaking love that console. Yeah. I mean, that was one of the only times in a console generation where a new generation started and you literally felt like you were in the future. Because like we had like 3D worlds, because we were so used to side scrollers, everything just going left and right, and the N64 just broke so many boundaries. I remember the first time playing Mario 64 and it blew my mind. Like, seeing Mario in a 3D world was freaking insane. So,
and that was such a good game. Like, it was a fun game, man. It was so fun.
It really was.
Yeah, the design, the level design, the little, like, you had the castle world, and then you had all the different levels.
For some reason, that game felt, like, scary. Like, as a kid playing that game, beating the castle all by yourself, like that felt like kind of like a scary Mario game, like in some weird kind of way for me. I don't know why.
No, so I feel like it was intimidating because you're used to Mario's side scroller and like 8 levels and like little flute and like, because even, well, I will say Mario 2 made me feel a little bit scared because it was so trippy and weird.
Yeah,
the music was all creepy and none of the characters behaved like the first one or the third one.
Yeah.
It was such a little acid trip.
Exactly.
But yeah, no, I definitely agree with you. The Nintendo 64 for me felt like Nintendo finally pushed that boundary. They experimented obviously with the controller, so there, I don't think to this day there's been a controller that looks like that. And I get that it's wonky, but they were willing to push that boundary.
Yeah.
Were they the first ones to introduce a joystick like that, or did PlayStation come out with something already? No, right?
I don't know. Adams.
I don't.
Do you remember that?
The PS1 did not have an analog joystick.
Okay, yeah. So then I remember the
joystick. At least not on launch.
Yeah, I think they got it. I think they added it later, right?
Later.
Or was that? Or did they wait to the PS2? I think they might have waited to the PS2.
Yeah, I think they waited to the PS2.
They might have.
There's no. Not on launch, I don't think.
No, I do think the little mini PS1 that they released
with
10 games. I thought that one did have joysticks. I could be wrong there.
Yeah, it was. I mean, at that time, I guess it didn't feel like a weird controller because we played a lot of games on it. So
it felt weird as hell.
There is,
especially as a kid with little hands, dude. Where was I supposed to hold it? My left hand, the left side, and the right in the middle.
You could hold it multiple ways because if the developers of the game were smart enough to where if they wanted to use the joystick, you could grip the joystick. You had your right bumper, you had your Z bumper, and then you had the joystick, and you could play it that way. Like, I don't remember a game forcing me to do joystick and D-pad. Like, you were usually centered around one or the other.
Yeah.
Or, like, the D-pad would be, like, these random buttons that you didn't really use all the time.
Mm-hmm.
But, no, yeah, I'm with you in regards to... because they obviously...
Oh, that's right. You never played Zelda. Because it did that. You used all four of the yellow buttons on the right. I'm pretty sure it used all of them.
Yeah, it did. I think the yellow buttons were like for the camera or something. Or maybe I'm thinking of Mario.
Smash use them all too?
I'll say again.
Didn't Smash use them all too?
I think so. No. I think Smash used everything on that damn controller.
Like in WWE. SmackDown, the joystick, you would just flick it so you can get your special going.
Yeah, wrestling games back then.
So the analog stick was released on PS1 in 97.
Oh, okay, so it was.
I want to, which is a year after 64. So it's very possible that it influenced them to do that.
Did an upgrade.
Yeah, that was kind of weird at first because we were so used to using just D-pads for so many years, and then like the stick just came out of nowhere. I'm like, wait a second, this is not an arcade. Like, what's going on? Yeah. Thanos in chat says WCW versus NWO. Yes, that is probably one of my favorite wrestling games of all time.
Yeah, I gotta go SmackDown, but then WCW versus NWO was my second.
Yeah, I freaking love that game.
I feel like they were all kind of copy-paste for the most part. The rosters were just different.
Yeah.
But
I was a kid, I didn't care.
And another thing that the Nintendo 64 did, again, like I said, they pushed a lot of boundaries, is, you know, obviously those before the internet was really still a thing.
Yeah.
But they opened it up to four players, right? Which is something they kind of kept in line with. And it really set the stage for Nintendo's strategy in terms of like multiplayer, but with people.
Nintendo has always been more group gaming friendly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I agree.
Because like GoldenEye, Gauntlet Legends, and a ton of other games like that came out on the 64, so you could play with your friends.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, GoldenEye was a classic. That was like my first real experience with like multiplayer gaming was GoldenEye, for sure.
Yeah, I remember that was the first time like one of the kids from school came over one weekend and he brought his two controllers. I had my two controllers.
Yeah.
And we just loaded up GoldenEye and it was like just amazing. I thought
you fight each other because y'all watching each other's screens.
Oh yeah. Screen watching was like,
I'm gonna peek. I don't care.
I didn't look. What are you talking about? All right, so I guess it's fair to say that N64 is your favorite console as well.
The nostalgia, the it was really like Nintendo's ode to like pushing the boundary, and I don't think they've kind of kept up with that, right? They've had these weird consoles that aren't like any of the other consoles.
Yeah,
the Wii was different. The Switch
was GameCube was strange.
GameCube was strange.
GameCube was very strange. Yeah, it was.
The reason the GameCube was more in line with like other consoles, because they had weird controllers, but other than that, it was just like a better performing N64.
Yeah, true indeed.
But then, like I said, then they got into like the weird stuff again with the Wii was kind of like revolutionary, and then the Switch kind of was a big deal as well with the mobility.
True.
But I think the Nintendo 64 is really where they took their first big step into like next level, I guess.
Okay. All right. So next question, we're going to jump into Bojo. What is your runner-up favorite console? Do you have a second favorite console?
I'll go with PlayStation 2 as my runner-up.
Okay.
Sega Genesis is my favorite. Runner-ups, definitely PlayStation 2. Solely for Kingdom Hearts. That game changed my life as a child.
Never got into it.
It's
I would smoke weed and run around with Donald Duck and Goofy killing bad guys.
World's worst healer.
This shit was wild.
So are you excited about Kingdom Hearts 4, Bojo?
I lost my damn mind whenever that was announced. I was so excited. I still am. And it's going to look so good.
It is.
I'm hoping for a Marvel or Star Wars world. Encanto would be cool. They have so many new Disney and
we're getting Final Fantasy things. World.
I know.
Wait, what?
I've never played a Final Fantasy game.
Oh my goodness.
The characters seem really cool.
Me neither.
From what I've seen in Kingdom Hearts, my knowledge of Adam's role, I can feel his hatred towards me growing.
Not hatred, it's disappointment.
There's a lot of disappointment in the room tonight, guys. What's going on? Jeez.
Well, when I was a kid, also, my grandparents thought anime was the devil and Pokemon were demons. So I wasn't allowed to play a lot of things.
Not far off with anime.
I wasn't allowed to play a lot of those games anyway. I only got away with Kingdom Hearts because it was Disney.
Yeah.
It's
a solid story, man.
I was a very sheltered child.
Now look at you.
Look at me now, a whole ass heathen.
Sheltered adult.
I just got taller. Nothing has changed.
So
I think PS2 has probably one of the best libraries.
Absolutely.
Of all gaming.
Sly Cooper is one of my favorite games of all time as well.
Oh, I forgot about Sly Cooper.
I've been playing through them again a little bit.
Okay. Let me see. Adams, what is your runner-up favorite console?
Dreamcast.
Same here.
That was way ahead of its time.
I think it was so far ahead of its time that nobody knew what to do with it.
Yeah,
they did not. That was such a good console, bro.
Because it has four of my all-time favorite games with Crazy Taxi, Shenmue, Sonic Adventures, and Ready to Rumble Boxing.
Oh, man. Ready to Rumble? Jeez. I forgot about that game.
When Dreamcast came out, that's all I played. They just stopped.
Yeah.
I think you hit the nail on the head with that. I don't think anybody knew how to handle that console. It was way ahead of its time.
We got a Dreamcast 2 coming out that I would spend any amount of money for it.
Oh yeah, for sure.
I always wondered like what derailed that console. I mean, performance was great. I don't know what the price point was.
So, for me, the biggest issue was my memory card kept fucking crashing. And I had to keep starting over.
So, maybe it was shitty quality?
I think...
But the memory card did have its own mini game on it, which was kind of dope.
Yes, I did like that. I did like that.
And the PS2 killed the Dreamcast.
Yeah, I think the problem was a lot of studios didn't support the Dreamcast at the time, and I think that's kind of why it started falling down the garbage pail, because nobody really supported it. Nobody was behind it. So
the developers weren't behind
it. Yeah, because, I mean, it had some good games, but didn't have enough.
Its library was pretty limited, right?
Yeah, there were some good games on there. It just mm-hmm. really wasn't a lot of games on there.
I remember my neighbor, they were a richer family than mine.
Mm-hmm.
And the kid got a Dreamcast, and they had a big screen TV. And mm-hmm. I remember the game he got was Killer Instinct, and it looked fucking awesome.
I used to love that game too. Killer Instinct was good.
Yeah, I always played the wolf because I knew how to do his little fatality. It was the easiest one. Hold B. Hold B. Yeah. You throw the little bat, and if it hits you, you're done.
Yeah, I freaking love that console, man. Ready to Rumble. I forgot about that game until Adam said it. I love that freaking game. It was awesome.
Literally, whenever we were talking earlier, I was trying to think of the name of it because all I could think of was a couple of the characters. And I was like, well, I could not think for the life of me.
Yeah, they had the tall, skinny dude with a throat.
Oh, yeah.
My favorite character was actually the old-timey English dude that would box like this all weird.
Yes.
Yeah,
that was my favorite guy.
Wasn't there like a giant woman, too?
You know what? I think they're, you know what? I'm about to look up some footage of that. Because...
No, I need to look.
Oh, the memories are flooding. I do see a picture of a woman, Bill Clinton.
Bill Clinton in the game?
It says Bill Clinton in the game.
Get out of here.
All I did was look up Ready to Rumble characters, and there it is. So you had Afro Thunder. We knew that one.
Afro Thunder.
Yes, that's...
It wasn't a woman. It was the big sumo wrestler guy. That was my favorite. I don't know why.
I can't find any good footage for you, chat, to play, because it's so old that it just looks like crap. <Yeah. laughs> It looks really bad, so I don't think I'm going to really play it. But that I remember seeing that game for the first time, and those graphics blew my mind. I was like, yo, it looks like real people in the ring. It was crazy.
And they didn't, but we didn't know back then.
We didn't know any better.
That's what's crazy about talking about nostalgia and video games and stuff is remember how real GTA looked? Remember how it's amazing.
GoldenEye was awesome, and it looks like shit.
And now we're mad if there isn't 4,000 hairs on a person's head whenever we play.
Exactly.
Where's our master? Remaster.
Where's my frames? Give me frames.
Yeah.
Seriously. All right, let me see. Adams, did I ask you your runner-up already? I think I did, right?
Yeah, it was Dreamcast.
All right. I think I got all you guys. My runner-up, same thing, Dreamcast. Freaking love that console. Like you said, way ahead of its time. Sucks that we're not going to get anything close to that again. I mean, but yeah. Sega lost the console battle, so.
Yep.
They
still exist. They still exist.
Yeah, they're still around. And which I did hear also, since you mentioned Crazy Taxi, they're thinking about bringing Crazy Taxi back along with Jet Set Radio. That's the rumor. Yep. Yeah. So
I would love Crazy Taxi.
That was fun. I never played Jet Set Radio.
But if they do Crazy Taxi, what are they going to do? Like Ubers? Like Uber? Like crazy Uber?
Crazy.
Because taxis aren't really around anymore.
Nah, they're around.
They're still.
I actually saw read an article on how the Uber in New York City is starting to not be able to keep up with demand.
Yeah.
So guess who they're leaning on to partner with? Taxi cabs.
Taxi cabs.
But taxis are a lot more prevalent around where I live, which is odd for West Virginia.
Really?
And I think taxi cabs are starting to get competitive with their rates now. Since Uber kind of realized, oh, shit, it actually costs more than this to actually stay profitable.
Yeah.
Their rates are starting to sort of level out. I don't remember. This is a weird tangent, isn't it?
Yeah, I was like, what a weird off-subject. The rate of taxi.
The taxi rate nowadays.
Juan always gets a tangent in there somewhere.
No, you gotta love the tangents, though. You gotta love the tangents. You know?
I just remember that. I remember I got dropped off by a taxi cab guy, and I paid him in cash, and the dude just pulls out this huge wad of money. I'm like, you guys aren't hurting.
Like, yeah.
Yeah, it was a big roll. I'm like, you must be dealing or something.
I've never been in a taxi or a Lyft or an Uber because I'm afraid to get murdered.
I'm afraid to get murdered. Wow. I can't remember the last time I've been in a taxi. I have no idea. We'll see. It'd be nice to see a new Crazy Taxi or Jet Set Radio because I freaking love Jet Set Radio. So,
you know, I'd like to see Sega come out with like a Game Gear 2 handheld portable console.
Dude, I want another handheld console. I was thinking about getting the Steam Deck, but I'm not sure if, like, I don't know if I would really use it. I mean, I would
play my Steam library anywhere.
I don't, and that's the thing. I don't have a big Steam library. I really don't.
So, I read about that is that you'll be able to download Xbox Game Pass and Epic onto a Steam Deck.
Oh. So,
your entire PC library can go with you.
So, it's worth it, right?
So, that changes things for me then.
Well, damn.
That changes
things. Now I have to come up with $700 right now.
How much does the Steam Deck cost?
There's various levels to it. I think it ranges from like 2 to 6.
Oh, that's right. You can get like different memory.
Yeah, SSDs and shit. Yeah. I pre-ordered it for $5, but I haven't heard about them being available, so we'll see.
Yeah, I thought I read something that's like late 2022. They'll have some more.
We're going to go on another tangent chat because I want to see how much this costs. So it looks like the base model is 400 for 64 gigs.
Oh, that's like one video game.
How much?
$400. Or it looks like that's for the base model. Yeah.
But do they have, what is it? You can actually put in your own memory card?
Yeah. So it comes...
like a slot?
Yeah, so it's 400 for 64, 529 for 256, and 649 for 512. That's a lot of money. I mean, you're practically carrying around like a little PC because you can connect it to a monitor too.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so it's you're pretty much paying for like a small PC, basically. Mm-hmm. So that's cool. All right, let's jump into our last question here. We'll start with Bojo. What unreleased game are you looking forward to this year?
Hogwarts Legacy. I'm real excited about it. Been a Harry Potter fan my whole life. Mm-hmm. After I was allowed.
After you were
allowed. And all. But I'm very excited. I love the open worldness and like the potential Elden Ringness of it, I guess. You get a broom, you get to tame magical creatures.
It does look pretty good, and I'm not a Harry Potter fan, but like I saw the trailer for it and like the behind the scenes, it looks pretty freaking good.
Yeah, I think Brutus and I are the resident Harry Potter nerds of DWF.
So, oh really?
Yeah, we've been talking about it for I think since it was announced how excited we were about it and to play it and stuff, and it's definitely gonna be interesting. And I don't want to get my hopes up too high because games that have came out so far this year have been fantastic.
Yeah.
So I don't know how long they can keep it going.
It has been a good year for games already.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's been a good year.
Yeah. Well, I mean, so what's the release date on Hogwarts? Do you know?
Late 2022. Nothing in stone or solid.
Yeah, I think they just said for the holiday season.
Interesting. Adam, are you going to be playing this?
Which holiday season?
I don't know.
4th of July.
Because I don't even recall them having any kind of like Christmassy scenes, but Harry Potter to me always screams like a Christmas type.
Yeah, me too. I don't know why. It feels like maybe a Christmas tale.
There's always a Christmas scene.
Is there?
Yeah.
I didn't even know.
Christmas in Harry Potter.
The first year is the first year that they get the sweaters that they wear. And then the second year, I think, is the year that Ron gets his dress robes. And then...
I thought the dress robes were the gift that got sent to him for the ball.
It was around Christmas time. It was the Yule ball, so it's a Christmas.
Oh, that makes sense. Yeah, you're right. A winter ball. Whatever.
Trust me, I know my Harry Potter.
Man, this game looks freaking beautiful too. By the way, side note.
Yeah.
When I saw the trailer and they were going over all the different stuff that is in it, like Bo just said, like training animals, fighting animals, like it's a ton of stuff they're throwing at us. And
yeah,
I mean, I hope they can deliver.
All of the locations as well, like Hogsmeade, Diagon Alley, Hogwarts, the Forbidden Forest.
You have your own house, right? Or your own home that you...
Yeah, I think so.
I think you're part of the house. Right. Yeah. Oh, it's like the Room of Requirement. You can customize and stuff.
Yeah, you have like your home base, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, is this multiplayer? Do you know?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, it is?
I don't think so.
To be like
it is a story game.
Yeah, I don't think it's multiplayer.
For some reason, I thought it was coming out as like a... Almost like an MMO.
I can't play with my friends!
That'd be cool, though. A Harry Potter MMO would be great.
That would be cool, actually.
Okay. Everybody riding around on fucking broomsticks. Quidditch mini game, dude. Why is that not happening?
Hey, you know what? That should be a multiplayer mode. What is it called? Quip or something? The little Quidditch. Broom. What is it?
Yeah, Quidditch.
Quidditch. Yeah, I'm Quidditch. Sorry. We're like disappointing Bojo right now. Like,
it's why I've disappointed you all throughout the podcast. So I get it.
Oh man,
jeez, my Louise. Turn to be disappointed. I get it. It's fine.
Yeah. All right. So, what about you, Adams? What game are you looking forward to most this year? Hopefully, it comes out this year. Whatever it is.
I don't really have one because the games that I wanted are already out.
Okay.
Gotham Heroes. I don't know if it's coming out this year, but I hope it does. Gotham Knights.
Oh yes, Gotham Knights.
Suicide Squad game comes out this year too.
Yeah, yeah. Suicide Squad, kill the Justice League because I want to kill Superman so bad.
I actually heard that Suicide Squad got delayed to 2023.
Yep.
Fucking Superman bullshit. We're not getting that one. That's but yeah, Gotham Knights. I'm definitely looking forward to that. Me and Adams talked about trying.
I
want to
say that
game.
One is multiplayer.
Yes.
Yeah, I think so.
Arkham Knights? Yeah.
I think it's three players.
Four.
Gotham Knights, sorry.
Four players? Oh, wow. I did not even know that.
Hold on. No.
Yeah, get a whole squad in on there.
It's like three Robins and then a Batgirl, right? Or something like that?
Red Hood, Nightwing, Robin, and Batgirl. Yeah. But, yeah. I mean, Nightwing is Dick Grayson, who was Robin Hood forever.
Adam's our residential information guy.
Yeah.
Aren't you the Batman guy though? You should have been ready with it.
Hey, I'm doing the producer stuff right now, so you know I'm letting you handle that.
He's busy.
I'm letting you handle that. But yeah, I'm definitely
delegating.
I'm definitely looking forward to this one. I was a big fan of the Arkham series games. I played all of them.
They were good.
They were really good. So I mean. Go ahead.
Am I the only one that's kind of crazy and thinks that whoever made Arkham Asylum and that series should do a Ninja Turtles game?
Oh, dude.
Yeah.
That would be fucking amazing.
Yeah.
Like, it would be the perfect company to make a Ninja Turtle game like that.
I'm waiting. Like, I know we're getting Shredder's Revenge, which is great. But yeah, I'm waiting for a modern-looking Ninja Turtles game. I've been wanting that for so many years.
That's what I'm saying, dude. And it would be awesome to see all their villains.
Exactly. Like, Turtles have some pretty awesome
Bebop
villains.
Rocksteady, Baxter Stockman.
Yes. What is it? Crane.
Would be awesome,
yes.
Dude.
Oh, I'm totally geeking out right now.
This fucking game looks amazing, though.
Yeah.
Gotham Knights.
It really does.
Look at that.
Yeah, I enjoyed
it. Got to get it on PS5, KJ.
Oh, Warner, yeah, for sure.
Warner makes some really great games because Shadow of Mordor. And those Lord of the Ring games.
Yeah.
Was it the same people? I know they were both Warner.
I think it was WB.
The fighting style and the graphics were similar, but they were fantastic games. So
only reason I have any semblance of hope in the Harry Potter game is because
it's Warner.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Warner doesn't disappoint.
No, yeah. I can't think of a bad Warner game. I'm sure there is, but I can't think of it.
Yeah, I don't think this one will let me down. I don't want to overhype myself with it, but I'm pretty optimistic about it, and I'm really looking forward to it. This game's, I think it was supposed to come out last year. It's been delayed, I think, twice now. So I'm hoping that it sticks to the schedule. I think it's coming out this fall, I think.
Yeah, October, November, somewhere in there.
Yeah, so just please don't delay it again. Unless you really have to, then do what you got to do.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, please don't put out a shit game.
Exactly. Take your time if you need to, but give it to me soon. Yo, Mr. Freeze looks dope in this trailer. Jeez Louise. So yeah, for me, I would have to say Gotham Knights is probably the same thing for me, mixed with Turtles in Time. So
yeah, the cameos for Gotham Knights is going to be pretty awesome too.
Oh yeah, for sure. For sure. Juana, what about you, buddy? What game are you looking forward to most this year?
Man, I don't know if it's, I don't think it's coming out this year, but I'm still, it's like the one game on my radar that I absolutely have to get.
Zelda? A new Zelda game? Yeah, Zelda, they are.
The Wild 92.
Oh, that's right. No, I need to try that game, because I know that Breath of the Wild, the first one, was amazing.
Yeah.
I'm too far gone to go back and play Ocarina of Time, but
never that.
Never.
It is not. What?
I don't.
Oh, that's right. You don't like retro games.
I'm not big on retro. I have gone back and tried retro, thinking that the nostalgia is going to carry me through, and then like 30 minutes into the game, I'm like,
this is not hitting for me.
So,
Halo.
I'm gonna say something that Brutus would probably say. If you play a game now and you can't like it, you probably didn't like it back then.
True indeed.
Yeah.
Very true. It's a possibility.
Possibility. Maybe. I don't know. Because, I mean, tastes mature. I mean, I don't like everything that I liked back when I was a kid.
Yeah. Well, it's time for you to start liking Zelda, because you're not a kid anymore. Mm-hmm.
So, no, honestly,
if you're gonna play a Zelda, it needs to be that one or A Link to the Past from Super Nintendo. One of those two should be your first one.
Well, like I said, I do want to. My
same goes for you, Bojo.
Games in the past, so I do want to try the Switch, and I know that they're on the Nintendo catalog, right? Like the online stuff.
Yeah, Switch has like their online back compat program that you can use.
I know Link to the Past, or whatever, that Nintendo NES title, that one got a remaster, didn't it?
I believe so.
I saw.
It's hard to say. Everything's been remastered at this point.
Yeah, no, but I know one of the older Zelda games did get a remaster. And so it has like nicer graphics, and but it's still that old 8-bit Zelda.
So in A Link to the Past, there's boots you can get to make you run fast. And you can just keep running into bookshelves over and over and over. And I used to do that as a kid because I thought it was so funny. Just full throttle it into everything.
Just bump it into walls. Side note, speaking of remakes and stuff like that, Adam, something you like.
For the record, we never said, I was just saying, Thor Ragnarok. That's Thor, right? I'm not Thor Ragnarok. Fucking God of War.
Assassin's Creed.
Is a Thor game coming out this year?
No. I'm getting my fucking movies in game.
We're gonna get Bro Thor trying to kill Kratos' kid.
Seriously.
I just, God of War is like one of my it is my all-time favorite series.
Yeah.
Of video games. Their pivot from what it was all the way through PS3, and then what it became in PS4 was phenomenal. It was
the 2018 version is leaps and bounds ahead of anything that they put out on prior consoles.
Yes, it's a freaking masterpiece.
Visual masterpiece. The gameplay was amazing. The storyline was.
You got some ketchup there,
great man.
It's barbecue sauce.
What kind of barbecue sauce?
Around making sure.
I was hoping to spray you in the face. I wish we got that.
Like, chat, clip that. Clip that, chat. Oh, man.
But yeah, that's my most forward, or my most game that I'm looking forward to. I thought it was supposed to come out later this year, but
well, it's still slated to come out this year. It was supposed to come out last winter, I think, and then they pushed it back. So I was going to say God of War for this year too, but I just feel like they're going to push it back again.
I think God of War Ragnarok is slated to be one of the last PS4 exclusives.
Yeah, I think so
after
too.
After that, they're not going to be making
it on PS4 anymore. Oh, yeah, because I just read an article. I read a headline.
Okay.
Jedi Fallen Order 2.
Yeah.
It's slated to only be PS5, PC, or Xbox.
I'll play that on my PS5.
I think we need that, man. I think we need to start moving forward. I get it. There's still a lot of people that don't have PS5s or new Xboxes, but I mean, yeah, these
shut them down.
Just turn it off. Yeah. Cut off the servers.
That's right. Juan's worried about a shortage.
I do think the lack of supply of PS5 consoles is probably unprecedented compared to other console releases.
The PS2 release.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
Because that was a nightmare for everybody.
Yeah, you could not get your hands on that for forever. Forever. I think the PS2 is still Sony's top selling console. I think
it is. I'm pretty sure.
Really?
Yeah, I mean,
PS in my house right now.
I remember the PS2.
Bojo, you were the reason for the drought.
I'm all up.
I just remember the PS3 being so damn expensive.
Oh yeah, the PS3 was what, like $600?
Yeah.
That big boy was like, oof, you had to work overtime for that.
But when it launched, it had full backwards compatibility with discs all the way back to PS1.
Yes, it did.
Yeah.
Yeah, yes, it did. And I think that, and it came with the Blu-ray player, which I actually ended up taking advantage of a lot.
That's only half true. It was backwards compatible unless the disc was blue, like they used to make them.
Oh yeah, I forgot the discs were blue. You're right. Mm-hmm. I completely forgot about that.
That's the only ones the PS3 wouldn't read, and it pissed me off because half my games that I liked were blue discs. They eventually fixed it, I think, and came out with another version.
They got rid of backwards compatibility at all.
Damn you!
That was the worst thing they ever did to PS3.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, true. Now we're trying to hopefully get some more backwards compatibility with the older consoles on the PS5 with PlayStation Plus new service that's coming out next month. Well, yeah, next month.
June.
Just because we haven't really shown it any love this entire episode or this entire conversation, I gotta say that my honorable mention gotta be the Xbox 360.
Oh, yeah.
I felt like
that's the 360
had really cool, like the UI, and I actually booted one up not too long ago, and it still held up as far as like the graphic interface and stuff like that. But the library was awesome. Microsoft had some really solid titles. Halo, which I know you hate, Adam, but Halo.
Modern Fable, Warfare 2?
Modern Warfare.
Oh, yeah, Modern Warfare.
Best of the Call of Duty franchise. Modern Warfare 2 and Black Ops. Yeah.
But they were also on PlayStation. So
yeah, but we're not talking about.
He's like, he was talking about the exclusives,
and then you're talking about shit that's on everything.
I'm just excited.
I agreed because I played all of my Call of Duty games on Xbox 360.
Yeah, me too. That's
same here.
I was going.
They had like a really good. If I remember correctly, I feel like Xbox had the better online experience compared to PlayStation. I could be wrong on that, but I thought I remember.
PS3, it was free, so.
Yeah, that was a big thing during that time. It was free on the PS3. I mean, Xbox was known for its multiplayer element in general with Xbox Live, because they were the first person to do like online live service kind of thing. So that's why Xbox was known more for like multiplayer. Basically, and then when PlayStation did it, they was like, "Oh well, we're going to give ours for free." Basically, and that kind of like changed the game.
Shit, it didn't matter which console you were on. If you were in a Modern Warfare 2 lobby, you were getting called every name that existed.
Oh yeah, true.
Doesn't matter. Yeah,
they did not discriminate.
Back when everybody hated everybody.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And nobody reported anybody.
I know. There was no report button. There was no ban. Yeah. There was none of that stuff like that.
Truly the Wild West.
Shape me into the woman gamer I am today.
You got called some shit back then. You just went and cried. Mute your mic. Who cares?
Yeah.
Exactly. It made you a better human. You know. Yeah. Now look at us.
Or a psycho.
Yeah.
Now we all yell at video games for money.
Exactly. Exactly.
Well, yeah, that's I have to throw that out there because we didn't touch the Xbox at all, and I remember when the original Xbox came out.
Shit, I could list 8 consoles in my top 10 before I get to an Xbox.
Yeah.
Wow.
Really? Wow.
I can, honestly, I could probably fill out a top 10 without mentioning Xbox because I never had one. So
that makes sense.
There's no nostalgia.
Yeah.
And I still think that PlayStation's exclusives are superior to Xbox's.
Oh yeah,
I agree. I agree. I thought Xbox, even today,
Xbox has Gears, Halo, Fable, and what other exclusives? If I asked you that question about PlayStation, you would probably list 30 right off the bat.
Yeah,
because it had Final Fantasy, Kingdom Hearts, it had Tomb Raiders.
God of War,
The Last of Us,
Infamous.
That is a good series, man. We need another Infamous game. Games. Me too. We need another Infamous. Uncharted. Yep. Freaking amazing.
Look at you go! I'm proud of you.
I know 2 games.
Horizon now.
Yeah.
Aloy is the future. For sure. I freaking love Aloy.
Aloy got fucking wrecked by Elden Ring. You need to slow down.
Yeah.
She did.
I was just having that conversation with Adams yesterday. Like, Horizon just can't get away from other big open world games. Every time a new Horizon game comes out, there's a big open world game right next to it. They just can't win.
Unfortunately, Elden Ring may be one of the best games in the last 5 years.
Will you guys be surprised if Elden Ring does not win Game of the Year this year?
I would be very surprised.
Yeah.
Whatever, if anything beats it, it's gonna have to be phenomenal. And I didn't even play Elden Ring.
I think if something beats it, it's gonna be Horizon or Tiny Tina's Wonderland.
Yeah.
Tiny Tina that good? Is it really that good?
It is.
Wow.
If Ragnarok releases this year, I think Elden Ring might lose Game of the Year if Ragnarok releases in November or later.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't even think about that. If Ragnarok doesn't come out till like December,
yes, it will make a very strong case for Game of the Year.
Yeah, I think that's probably the only game that can possibly beat it. Is Ragnarok?
I don't think Horizon or Tiny Tina's have really scratched the success of Elden Ring.
Me either, but they're.
They're up there, but not. I still think like if Horizon's a 5, Elden Ring's a 10.
Yeah,
I agree. There are people still playing Elden Ring. Mm-hmm. I don't see a whole lot of people
on like their playing. 80th playthrough.
Yeah. It's become like a meme culture. Like
it is
over like social media.
If I scroll TikTok, I'll get through 35 videos of Elden Ring before I get to anything else.
Yeah.
I don't think Tiny Tina's is gonna hold up.
So Hogwarts Legacy may have a chance.
True.
I don't think it has a chance at all.
It depends on the story and everything that goes with it.
Yeah.
If Hogwarts is less than 30 hours, it's not got a chance.
True.
Ragnarok will have a chance.
What about...
Very, very good one.
What about that Microsoft game that's coming out that they're going to announce next month? What is that big game that they're working on?
They're like, I know Forspoken, and then there's another one, Starcaller or something like that.
Star Citizen?
No, Star.
Nope.
What the heck is the game? I gotta Google it.
It's not Starcaller. I just seen it because I had a list up of 22 games coming out.
Starfield,
there we go.
I don't know enough about it to say yay or nay.
I don't either.
But the crazy thing is the internet is so hyped about that game, even though nobody knows anything about it. Everybody's like, oh, it's going to be Game of the Year. It's going to be magnificent. It's going to be Elden Ring. We haven't really even seen gameplay yet, you know? But, I mean...
Yeah.
The only thing I've really ever heard about that game was I was watching a Carnage stream, And he said he's never seen a development studio miss their targets as much as that studio. Like, if they say they're going to get to this phase of the game in November, it's like February. So I haven't heard anything else other than that.
I mean, Bethesda is known to do that. They're known to talk about a game but not show you anything until, like...
Is that who's making it?
Yeah.
Oh, it's a Bethesda game?
You don't think so?
No. They have failed so much.
Wow. In the last
several years. Fallout 76 was a flop.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Outer Worlds was fun, but it was not to the standard.
It was not memorable, no.
Who owns it? Microsoft owns Bethesda now?
Yeah.
Yeah. The fail of Fallout 76 made me extra sad because I'm a big Fallout fan. And I'm from West Virginia. So, like, I was very excited to, like, play through the wasteland that is here.
I put, like, 50 hours in that game. And then I was like, this sucks. Why am I still doing this?
Yeah, no, it was not enjoyable at all.
Which kind of sucks because Fallout 4 is one of my favorite games.
Mm-hmm. Fallout,
New Vegas is the best.
I love 3. Fallout 3 was my game.
That was the one that got me introduced to the series.
Yeah, same here.
Fallout 3, yeah.
Which sucks because it was after New Vegas, right? And that's the one that like a ton of people
No,
love. It was Fallout 3, New Vegas, Fallout 4.
I think that was when I was traveling a lot for work, so I never really had access to a console.
That's going to really suck.
They are supposed to be starting on a new New Vegas.
Yeah, I did hear about that.
We won't have to pay for that Star game because it'll be on Game Pass.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, it'll just suck if Bethesda drops the ball because this game has so much hype. So much hype. I mean, if this game lives up to the hype, there could be a chance that it might challenge Elden Ring.
I don't know, man. We've had 3 games this year live up to the hype. I can't see anymore.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know
how long this. Yeah,
like the odds are against us.
Yeah,
with the exception of Ragnarok, there's no way Ragnarok's a bad game.
Things have been too good for too long. There's no way that it stays this way all year.
Yeah, true indeed.
You can always trust a Sony exclusive to come out solid.
That is true. That is
like,
true.
I'm not saying it's a great game, but you can trust it to come out like not buggy or stupid.
Finished?
I don't know, man. The last like 10 titles they've released have been absolutely amazing.
Oh, I agree. I'm not ever going to give it the benefit. Well, I'll give it the benefit of the doubt, but I'm not going to certify it a banger pre-release. You know what I'm saying?
I mean,
that's just the gamer in me, right? But I do think Ragnarok is going to be a pretty fucking amazing game.
Yeah, because just like you guys said, like how often have we had a bad PlayStation first party exclusive?
Last of Us 2 was fantastic.
It just doesn't happen.
I can't remember.
So I mean,
and I usually remember shit.
He's the one to hold a grudge on a bad video game.
Yeah,
I still hold a grudge. I'm still holding a very big grudge against fucking Square Enix and Avengers.
Oh yeah, same here.
So bad.
I was really upset. I wanted that to be good.
I didn't have any problems playing it.
I had so much fun in the game with Iron Man, and it's unfortunate because that's like the only character I was able to play because the game was broken. Who makes a campaign without a fucking restart? Like you couldn't restart a campaign.
I just think that game should have just been a story game, like a single player experience, and then just
should have been what Guardians of the Galaxy was.
Yeah, exactly. It should have just been that.
Oh, Guardians was so good.
Guardians was good.
On Game Pass now.
Yeah, it's on Game Pass.
Yeah, I just rolled credits on that. Yeah, it's definitely worth it. All right, guys. So before we get out of here, Adams, is there anything that you want to share with the people, promote, or share with the people?
Come back to me. I wasn't ready.
Bojo.
I wasn't ready.
Wasn't ready.
I'm hoping that when he gets back to me, you guys say everything, and then I don't have to say nothing.
I got to keep on your toes.
I have 2 things. Look at this cool controller that I have for PS4 that looks like a PS1 controller.
I wanted that exclusive console when they launched it. The PS4 Classic Edition. But my wife was like, we don't have money. It's like,
I wanted that so bad, dude. I was trying everything I could to get it, and I just couldn't get it.
See, that's the one. I was really
I did get the Spider-Man exclusive one, though.
You suck, Adams.
Oh, that's such a great game, too.
Sorry, Bojo. Go ahead. We didn't mean to cut you off.
Yeah.
Can I plug a stream thing on your stream?
Sure. Plug whatever you want, girl.
So, June 18th, Divided We Fall Gaming is doing a charity stream for Extra Life. Our goal is to raise $500. All of our stream team is going to be a part of it. It's going to be a good time. It's going to be an all-day thing. We're going to be doing punishments, rewards, whatever, for each goal that we hit. It's going to be a good time. Come out, hang out, spend money, give the children your money for games, hospital. It's a good cost. My words got jumbled there at the end, but you get what I'm saying. I'm really excited about it. So, two of our annual streams we do a year. I'm just really excited about it.
Spend your money on the kids, guys. Spend your money on the kids.
Yeah, for sure. The summer one's actually it's a new charity for us. We've never done
the first one.
Yeah.
Inaugural? Is that the word?
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah.
Inaugural summer.
It makes us feel official.
You are official when you can add inaugural
charity.
And then in December will be our third year doing the Toys for Tots.
Is it really the third year?
3 years.
Yeah.
Wow.
I'm really.
Let's not say this like it's October. Okay, we're still in the first half of the year. This year's already going too fast. It's already gonna be May.
It really is.
Chill out.
I'm just excited.
Let's start breaking out the Christmas tree, guys. Let's
go. I'll set it up right now. Don't touch me.
I'm okay with that. Yeah, I love Christmas. If it was year round, I'd be fine with it.
True D team here.
Yeah, but in the charity,
year round is not good.
For all of KJ's people, are we posting this one, this audio, to our podcast as well?
Yeah.
Yep.
Yep. So, KJ's people, obviously you know about KJ's podcast, but we have one as well.
Jeez.
The PvP podcast.
Adams is like, really?
This is why he should have went first.
Why? I never would have mentioned the charity stream because I was put on the spot and didn't like it.
Yeah, actually, Bojo had the best plug.
No, plugs weren't on our little talking notes thing, okay? I didn't see plugs anywhere.
Yes, they were. Yes, they were.
Yes, they were.
Hey, well, I see them.
Anyway.
I'll put the word plugs next time. Plug here. Nah, sorry. Go ahead, Juan.
You ready now?
What's your name?
Or Adams.
Yeah, I was just plugging our podcast.
Well, yeah, I guess you're right. They did kind of plug everything for you already.
Nope, I got one. Okay. New to the Divided We Fall Discord is trivia nights every 2 weeks.
Oh,
we got it tomorrow. True. So if you want to test your knowledge on random shit, join our Discord and be there 8:30 Eastern.
Bojo.
Yeah, you don't lose to anybody. Bojo.
And the trivia master.
We got two trivia games that I made and then a bunch that we can choose from if we still want to keep going.
I'm gonna have to jump in with you guys tomorrow night, actually, because I missed the last one. So yeah, I'll make sure I leave all those links in the show notes for everybody listening on the JHouze Radio side, so you guys can check out DWF and show them some love and support. And one last thing before we go: do you guys have any recommendations for anything? A game, book, tech, movie, candy.
The last one on Comic Gark. Ninja Turtles. Read that.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, that was good.
It should be done. The last issue should be out soon.
Okay.
They pushed it back like 6 months. Made me sad.
Everything's getting delayed.
It's one of the best comic arcs I've ever read.
Awesome, awesome. Awesome sauce. Bojo, what are you recommending?
Watch the Sonic movies. I slept on them for very long. They're very good movies. Like,
I saw the first one. It's awesome.
The second one's amazing. Like, it's so good.
Really?
Oh, it came out yesterday. Sorry, didn't mean to interrupt.
the new Ronin?
Yeah.
Hell yeah. We're going to have to pick that up.
It's going to hurt, dude. It's going to hurt my feels.
Yeah, it is going to hit us right in the feels. It's the last one, right?
Juan, you're frozen, buddy.
Yeah, like, I saw that. I don't
you're
know
like frozen in an amazing like yeah, pose, I don't though. Like that. No, it's a good pose. A nice pose. It's your good side for sure.
Yeah.
He ain't got a good side.
No. Jeez Louise.
See, Chad, that's the kind of shenanigans you get in Discord.
Yes, yes, sir. Yes, sir. So what are you I'm sorry, Bojo, I don't know if you were still going on with your Sonic thing.
I don't even know what I was saying.
Oh.
I ask her the same question to get a completely different answer.
Yeah. I'm playing with the barbecue sauce packets again. Sorry.
She recommends barbecue for Mario.
She recommends barbecue sauce and Sonic movies. Not in that same order, though.
Yeah.
There we go. Yep, barbecue
that's
sauce.
My two, that's there my things.
Go. Eat more barbecue sauce.
Yep. On everything.
Jeez Louise. Juan, you got anything you want to recommend before we get out of here?
Sure. I got two. One, because I kind of slept on it, but now that, and it's new, but Moon Knight, if anybody's been kind of hesitant on it, it's a really good show. I just watched the fifth episode yesterday, and it's a good show. Like, it's a good story. I don't think it's as action-packed as some of the other ones, but it's still good. Especially if you're a fan of the Egyptian mythology, that part's really fun.
Definitely a good introduction to a new hero. That's not
yeah.
like the Avengers.
Yeah, it is very different. I like the Egyptian mythology, but I'm kind of on the show right now. That's okay.
So yeah. A couple of things I saw. One, it might actually be a limited series run. So okay. the main guy, Isaac, whatever his name is.
Yeah, I think it's Isaac.
What is it?
Oscar Isaac.
Oscar yeah. Isaac, there you go. He's only signed on for one season, 1 year. And apparently the show for the Emmys nominations or considerations, it got entered into the limited series run. So there's no plan to keep going with it.
Oh,
as far
okay.
as the show goes. Maybe. Who knows, right?
Well, they said the same thing about WandaVision, but we're getting a season two of that.
We're getting a season two of WandaVision?
I'm pretty sure.
What?
I haven't gotten
nope.
any.
Nope.
Don't tell me that. I freaking love WandaVision.
Maybe.
Bojo, do not get my hopes up.
I heard it wasn't.
WandaVision season 2?
Listen.
No, it's no,
from
WandaVision.
This article.
I've scrolled 8 things and they all say something different.
Oh, because they turned it into Agatha House of Harkness. It was rumored they were going to do a season 2. But they turned it into House of Harkness.
Yeah, we talked about it. I'm excited that Agatha's getting her own show because I like that chick that played her. She's hilarious.
I like her too, yeah.
I love Catherine Hahn so much.
Yeah,
she's freaking awesome.
I liked her in Step Brothers.
Me too.
Yeah, she's freaking awesome.
She's so aggressive.
She really is.
She's aggressive in like everything, dude. She really is.
Yeah. I like her in Bad Moms a lot.
Yeah. Yeah.
I liked her in what's the movie? The political campaign one.
Everything. I like her in everything.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she's always sort of that. Yeah, I enjoyed her. She was great in WandaVision, like awesome comedic relief there.
Absolutely.
For sure. So my recommendation before we get out of here, Apple TV Plus. Subscribe to it. Check it out. Really? Get a free trial. Yeah, amazing shows. Amazing shows. I was talking to Adams about Severance, your latest hit show on there.
Wild, yeah.
Adams, I will never talk to you again until you watch that show.
Yeah. I barely got time to watch anything.
Okay. I'll let you slide
Adams
for now.
Works and games. Games and works.
But
what are you doing
just
to your face, Bojo? Yep, you definitely put a fucking line down your face. Clip
did
it.
She just did you get sauce on your oh
and
wow.
then she was surprised when there was a mark.
I didn't I'm realize that there was so makeup on it.
I just saw it on the Twitch because of the delay.
It's too late, Bojo. It's clipped. It is forever in the internet. Whatever. I can't even talk right now. It's clipped. We got you.
Yep, there it is. Thank and you, it's bro. It's amazing watching it the second time.
That's why we bought you here, Bojo. We bought you here for the laughs.
That's okay? Why I can't be taken out in public because I embarrassed myself.
Yeah, that's okay though. We still love you. But yeah, Apple TV Plus, check it out. There's a lot of great shows on there. There's a lot of shows that are winning like like awards. One show that I watched, I can't even think of the name of it. I think it's called Coda. They have an actor who is the first deaf actor to win a Best Actor award, which means a lot to me. Yeah, it's a really good show. It means a lot to me because I have a son who is deaf, so it's really nice to see that. A lot of people are sleeping on Apple TV, man. If you don't have Apple TV, you gotta freaking get it. I don't know why that link didn't pop up in chat, Adams. Probably because of my permissions thing. I gotta add you to my my special list. My special list, whatever they call it on Twitch.
Can you download that clip and send it to me? Because it makes me laugh.
Yes, I will download that clip.
I want unrestricted access to that clip.
It's
when you're having a bad day.
It's not as good as when she almost killed herself in the chair. But it's,
oh my
it's,
god, that was awful.
Wait, I want to hear that. I want to hear that before we get out of here. What do you mean she almost killed herself in the chair?
It was one of the first podcasts, probably the only one we did like recorded with video.
Yeah.
And I leaned back in Jeff's chair, and it was like all loosey goosey, and I almost fell out of the chair backwards.
Wait, on stream?
Yeah, good times.
Yeah.
Oh,
it's recorded.
Wow.
It's on YouTube somewhere, right?
Yeah,
it's on our DWF channel that's been neglected.
In the first 30 seconds, I think.
Yeah, guys, check them out on YouTube. DWF on YouTube. What is it? DWF Gaming on YouTube?
That sounds right.
Look for that clip. I want you to go to that channel just to find that clip of Bojo nearly killing herself. Give it a like, give it a follow, give it a sub. Other than that, thanks, Bojo. Thanks, Juan. Thanks, Adams. Thank you guys for hanging out. Make sure you guys check out the DWF community for anybody who's here on the JHouze Radio side, and anybody on the DWF side, check out JHouze Radio. You might like it. No problem, guys. We're signing off. No problem. Thank you for being here. And thank you, DWF, for allowing me to be here with you guys, too. All right, guys, we're out of here. Peace and chicken grease.
Bye.